Until the 19th century, Europeans thought that entering the New World, North America, was entirely impractical. To them, the North American continent was nothing but a vast wilderness. Spain, a great power at the time, had no interest in North American continent, and Napoleon sold one-third of the United States for only $2 million. The continent was completely out of their interest, just as we are now, indifferent to the plain Mars. Have you ever heard of a game StarCraft? In StarCraft, the future human race has a technology to turn a planet into a habitable place. In the game, even the planet showered with nuclear weapon can be transformed into the place where plants grow within just 2 years. Scientists are searching for planets capable of terraforming. However, there are still many opinions that Mars is the most suitable place. Why Mars? In the previous video, I introduced planets similar to the Earth, like TRAPPIST-1e and Alpha Centauri. But why do we have to terraform Mars instead of more habitable planets? Of course, the environment is similar to ours on the planets, but they are outside the solar system, which is too far away. For now, what we can choose are neighboring planets or their satellites in the solar system. Although they are in the solar system, Jupiter's Europa and Saturn's Titan are still far away. On Venus, which is close to the Earth, the temperature is too high and it's difficult to remove sulfuric acid clouds. To terraform Mars, several challenges must be solved. However, the most difficult and important task is to make the atmosphere on Mars similar to that of the Earth. When comparing the Earth and Mars, one of the most important differences is the presence of an atmosphere. Mars has a thin atmosphere, and the atmospheric pressure is only 0.6% of the Earth. Once you enter Mars, you can hardly breathe since the air is scarce. In addition, because of thin air, the surface of Mars is directly exposed to solar radiation, and life is difficult to be born. Scientists say, in the past, there might have been water and sufficient atmosphere on Mars. What made Mars a devastated planet? Mars has a small atmosphere because it is exposed to the solar wind. The Earth is surrounded by a magnetic field caused by rock convection inside the Earth. The magnetic field blocks the solar wind for a long time, so the atmosphere is not blown away by the solar wind. Unlike the Earth, Mars has no liquid rock inside it, so the magnetic field is only 0.125% of the Earth. Because of this, Mars had been exposed to the solar wind for a long time and the atmosphere was blown away. That's not all. The composition of the atmosphere on Mars is very different from that of the Earth. Mars' atmosphere is composed of 96% carbon dioxide and very little oxygen. Mars has a thin atmosphere with little oxygen. Is it possible to create an atmosphere where humans can survive? The first thing we need to do to terraform Mars is thickening the atmosphere. When the atmosphere gets thicker, the density of an air increases, and we can finally accomplish similar air pressure to the Earth. The most important thing in terraforming Mars is making Earth-like atmospheric pressure. So, what do we need to thicken the atmosphere? Carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases. Ironically, the harmful substance causing environmental problems on the Earth could be useful for terraforming Mars. Martian polar ice cap contains water and carbon dioxide in the form of ice. If we could melt the frozen carbon dioxide and spread it into the air, we could make the atmosphere thicker. However, this method has limitations. If the carbon dioxide in the Martian pole is released, the atmospheric pressure on Mars will be twice as high as it is now. But this is 100 times less than the target, one atmosphere. Elon Musk thought about a way to dissolve more carbon dioxide. On Twitter, he suggested dropping a nuclear bomb to warm Mars and melt the frozen carbon dioxide buried all over the planet. However, the carbon dioxide deposits were so deep that nuclear bombs alone cannot melt them. 3 days after, he proposed another method again, reflecting the sun's heat to Mars with a large space mirror. This method, first proposed by Rigel Oida at the University of Arizona in 2006, does not require additional work to remove radioactivity after dropping a nuclear bomb. But it is hard to block harmful gamma rays and finance $1 trillion. If the amount of CO2 buried on Mars is not enough to thicken the atmosphere, we can also burn fossil fuels to create carbon dioxide and greenhouse gases. On the Earth, the temperature is rising every year, even though we are limiting greenhouse gases. But what if we do not suppress it, but instead try to create greenhouse gases? The temperature on Mars may rise soon. But from where do we get all the fossil fuel? Since there is no fossil fuel on Mars, we should bring them from the Earth, but it costs too much to convey that much fossil fuel. The world's space powers are preparing to mine the lunar resources and transport them to the Earth. In the future, if the technical and economic difficulties of resource transportation are resolved, fossil fuels will be transported to Mars. AI robots may make products in Mars factory. And one day, the Amazon Mars branch will provide rocket delivery service to the Earth. Do you remember the chalk used by teachers in the classroom? Carbonate minerals such as this chalk can release carbon dioxide when combined with acid. In 2008, at the Mars physics landing site, carbonate minerals are discovered in Martian soil. Satellites have collected indications that carbonate minerals may be present throughout Mars. Also, the rover was able to collect acidic material from the surface of Mars. If these two materials are widely spread all over Mars, and they are combined, it may be possible to generate large amounts of carbon dioxide. As I mentioned earlier, the reason why the atmosphere is thin on Mars is because the solar wind blew away the atmosphere. Because of this, some articles say that it is very important to form an artificial magnetic field on Mars to block the solar wind. They say forming an atmosphere on Mars is impossible because creating an artificial magnetic field is difficult. In conclusion, this is a false claim. The solar wind slowly blows the atmosphere over millions of years, not in a short period of time. In 2015, NASA sent the MAVEN satellite to Mars to observe the atmosphere of Mars. The solar wind was blowing 100 grams of Martian atmosphere every second. It means that less than 10 tons of atmosphere is blown away from Mars every day. The mass of the atmosphere on Mars is 25 teratons, so the amount blown away every day is relatively very small. When Mars is left without any maintenance, it takes billions of years for a solar wind to completely blow away the entire atmosphere of Mars. Therefore, in thousands of years, solar wind does not matter. It is a misunderstanding caused by the sentence, "The solar wind blows the atmosphere." Forming an artificial magnetic field is not a main issue of terraforming Mars. In fact, terraforming is only meaningful when humans exist as organisms. If most of the human body is mechanized like cyborg, humans will be able to survive in an environment different from the Earth. They will withstand high or low temperatures and survive in the vacuum. The reason for terraforming is completely gone. It may be a waste to spend a lot of money on terraforming, and we need to consider whether humanity will always be organic. In the economical viewpoint, it's better to make the human body viable in space than terraform other planets, if humans can accept a machine body. But can it be called a human?